Yes, I mean, everybody's talking about AI all the time. What people tend to not take into account is that most of the time, if you're operating out in the ocean, you don't have fiber internet. Okay? So this whole notion of having data centers in Utah or Texas or wherever you're going to put them that you can just dial into and use your tokens to do your calculations and inference models, well, that doesn't work when you're hundreds of miles away from land.
All right, welcome inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Philipp Stratmann. He is the CEO of Ocean Power Technologies. And Philipp, it's great to see you again. How are you?
Doing well, Steve. Great to be on again.
Yeah, I know you've been traveling a lot, getting out and spreading the message about what the company does, and that includes at a conference in the United Arab Emirates, and a really strong conference, a lot of people there, right, Philipp?
We were super excited to be at IDEX and NAVDEX last week in Abu Dhabi. We had a good team from our side over there. We actually had one of our vehicles there, and I think that was really the key differentiator. Now, this wasn't a standing around and trying to find new contacts to talk to. This was us every single day during the entire week demonstrating the capabilities of our autonomous vehicles and the versatility and utility that platform offers you to do all sorts of jobs and deliver all sorts of payloads, be that below the water, on the surface, or launching aerial.
Philip, I know there's been a lot of talk around the world about AI and what's going on with AI, and that's really at the center of what you're doing and how important Ocean AI is. And I know you completed a white paper actually that people can read on your website talking more about where AI is headed towards as far as the ocean is concerned.
Yes, I mean, everybody's talking about AI all the time. What people tend to not take into account is that most of the time, if you're operating out in the ocean, you don't have fiber internet. Okay? So this whole notion of having data centers in Utah or Texas or wherever you're going to put them that you can just dial into and use your tokens to do your calculations and inference models, well, that doesn't work when you're hundreds of miles away from land. And at best, you have a spotty connection. And most of the time, if you're looking at the security application, you're going to have to presume you're either in communications constrained or worse, communications denied environments. So the only way all of this autonomy that everybody's talking about is going to work is by doing it as AI at the edge. Now, that requires different types of models. But it also requires you to now have access to power out in the ocean. And having buoys that you can place out there that generate their own power, that can power alternative and very specific models that are targeted at the specific operations you're trying to do out in the ocean, that can then task your autonomous assets whilst you're out in the ocean. That is where that next frontier lies. And I think that is what we're super excited about starting to push into the market.
Yeah, and you're sending that message. You sent it obviously at the United Arab Emirates. You're also sending it on a number of other places that you're going to be, a series of conferences that are coming up, Southeast Asia, the UK, Washington, Hawaii. You're going to be all over the place bringing that kind of message to people, right?
Between myself and the rest of our team, we're going to be talking at the defense and security meetings that take place in the Pacific next week. We've got some of our team taking place in a trade mission to Southeast Asia that takes place in March. There's a couple of meetings taking place around sort of, more the commercial side of the industry in the United Kingdom. And then obviously early April is CS Space in Washington, D.C., where, we're very excited to be exhibiting our systems and together with some of our partners like Red Cat, showcasing the ability of what you can bring to the table when you start delivering edge-based AI with autonomy that then enables kind of multi-domain operations in the ocean.
Yeah. And one last thing I want to ask you, all these conversations are important, and those contracts are important, but getting the actual hardware to people is obviously the key. Is that something that you really focus on a lot within the Ocean Power?
Yes, we do. I think one thing we are very proud of is the fact that these are commercially available systems. We do dual-use technology, and it is available right now. We continuously ship systems and solutions to our customers, be they domestic or overseas, and we have the ability to go and enter into conversations that result in these conferences and white papers and everything else that we discuss, but move from there very quickly into, okay, that's great. So why don't we deliver some buoys to you? Why don't we deliver some vehicles to you? And you can actually start working this through demonstrations that, you know, we feel comfortable will then lead into larger term projects and programs. I think the benefit of that, this isn't vaporware. This is real. These are hard systems that exist right now. And it, you know, we can ship them at, I don't want to say a moment's notice because this isn't quite Amazon, but they can be moved out very quickly in terms of being in the hands of the end user that actually has a requirement.
Makes a lot of sense. Philip, thank you so much. Great update. Enjoy the conference row. It's going to be a busy one, and we'll talk to you on the road somewhere.
Appreciate it. Thank you, Steve. Good to be on.
All right, Philip Stratmann, the CEO of Ocean Power Technologies.